Hi, I'm Simon Strasser. I'm the staff scientist for Space Place here on the fourth floor at Science North. Gravity well has exactly the shape of the gravitational field around the sun or any other object. So it sort of looks like a funnel, and it goes down steeper and steeper so we can make orbits, for example, just the way they happen around the sun with planets. Watch this. So that's a circular orbit. Now we could also make an elliptical orbit. In that case, what we would do is we would shoot this ball bearing more towards the center. So let's try that. And there we have an elliptical orbit. Now we see in this case, the speed actually picks up quite a bit. We can see when we go towards the center, it's more gravity and it picks up speed, just how a comet goes around the sun and picks up speed. So it goes faster when it's close to the sun, slower when it's far away. Okay, the next thing I want to demonstrate is how we can create collisions. So we know that in the solar system, there can be huge collisions between objects. So for example, about 1.8 billion years ago, there was a huge asteroid, about 10 to 15 kilometers across, that crashed into the Earth, and it created what we call the Sudbury Basin today. So that's what we're gonna see next. Okay, so you can see our first ball bearing is now in a nice circular orbit. And now I'm gonna let my second ball bearing go. And this one has an elliptical orbit. And so because it has an ellipse, it's gonna go across the circle from time to time, and we're gonna get a collision. So let's just wait and see. Okay, so this time now we're using two ball bearings about the same size. So our planet that's going in a circular orbit is now about the same size as the object that's gonna hit it. And you're gonna see that the planet is gonna be really disturbed in its orbit. It's not gonna stay the same. So when you have two objects about the same size hitting each other, it can really affect the orbit, where a planet that's getting hit by a much smaller object probably won't really change its orbit a lot. As we're watching this ball bearing go towards the center, we actually observe that gradually the orbit goes closer and closer to the center. So it's not staying on its orbit. Well, we know that planets, they don't crash into the sun. So what's going on here? Well, in this case, we actually have some friction, and that's gradually slowing the ball bearing down. So eventually it's gonna go right into the center and disappear. So that would be more like the case of something that might be caught around a black hole, because there, an object might gradually lose energy and gradually spiral into the black hole. And of course, once it's in there, it will never be able to escape. Okay, just before we're done here, let's have some fun. Let's see what happens if we let 100 ball bearings all go down at once.